Nazeem Hussain.
Hello. I'm probably going to get sued now.
Yeah, you will.
I use two fingers.
We can't endorse that. We can't endorse
that. And also, quick correction, not one of the funniest, like the funniest. The funniest.
I mean, yeah. I got in there and edited that script.
Yeah. But now, seriously, how does it feel to be a proper published author with Hilarious Hyena?
It's better being called an author. Like when you're on the departure card, you get to write your occupation.
Yeah.
Every time you write comedian, yeah. I always go, oh, tell us a joke. But now, I can write author. They'll probably, say write me a book. But it's more understood. Like it's also like I feel like my extended family really haven't really gotten their heads around what it means to be a comedian. My mum never really explained it properly. Like she tells her sisters in Sri Lanka that I'm a comedian. He tells jokes to strangers. He's very good at it. He's quite famous. But they don't get I do it in this context or in a theatre. They think I just go up to people like Woolies with a clipboard and I'm like, knock, knock, can I have some cash?
In fairness, you kind of do that as well.
That's also what I do.
Yeah, I've actually seen that footage. It's verifiable. But we've got... Harry is the star of the book, Harry the Hyena, and I've been told that it's like Nazeem. As a hyena.
Well,
have you not heard him laugh?
Perfect. People have always said that I laugh like a hyena. Okay, now I'm getting how the writing came out. But anyway, yeah it's kind of like he's the hyena version.
Hyena?
Because you know what? Hyenas are like, just remember The Lion King, right? They were the villainized group of characters that lived in the ghetto and they were bad. Why? Just because they wanted to eat? Like, remember, all the other animals were just like, stay away. Don't eat. You're not allowed to leave the Shadowland. But really, they were just, just other. So I felt like I related most of those animals because growing up, we were pretty broke, We came from like a pretty big intergenerational family. Humor was a big part of who we were.
But not anymore, bro. You're a rich ass.
I am rolling in it.
If we were all in the book, which I'm surprised we're not, to be totally honest, what would we be? Which animals would we be?
Oh, God. You'd be a lion because you're a king.
No, I
wouldn't.
I was going to say Benny the Blue Wren, but anyway.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, a wren. I was not thinking.
I think you're really wise, so I reckon you'd be an owl.
An owl? Yeah. Oh, I love that. I was going to say a wombat.
Or a wombat.
I'm quite lazy.
Hamish has got like maybe a wolf because you've got like Jacob from Twilight vibes. Just that's a compliment. Not that you're hairy, but like you're probably.
I'm hairy.
He's very.
You're very attractive. Or a buffalo. No, anyway. and you'd be like a possum. Because you're magic. Possum magic.
Oh, okay.
And you're always...
She scratches the roof.
I was going to say.
I'm always under
and you keep
night.
Us up all night.
Nazeem, did you write the book because you become a father or, is it maybe the mother looking down at you saying, Nazeem, it is time to become an author?
It's a bit of that. I mean, I did go to uni and study law and science and then... became a comedian and had to pay off a very large hex debt. Yep.
Which is a joke as well.
Absolutely. It was something to do over lockdown. Before, like a few years ago, Scholastic, the publisher, came to me and said, would you like to write a book? And I was like, listen, I'm real busy. I've got a lot of live work. I've got gigs here and there. And then lockdown happened and I was like, actually, I've got a bit of time.
Are you blaming Scholastic for the COVID pandemic? Is that what you're saying?
I'm thanking Scholastic for believing in me when I even didn't.
That's beautiful.
I'm thanking for the great deal. Maybe next time we can up the work. But, as a dad, I feel like, I've dedicated the book to my kids and now I can, if they ever misbehave, I can be like, listen, mate, I have written a book for you. Just
be better.
Clean your room.
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
Message from Pete Hellier. He says, if you come near Frankie Fish on the charts, you're never coming back.
That was also my ulterior motive. I'm coming after you, Pete, and Ando. Right?
Hilarious Hyena is out everywhere tomorrow. Nazeem, great to see you, mate.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.